And guess who's downplaying the whole thing? You guessed it, the left and the mainstream clueless media.
The right sets the agenda. They decide that there's a border crisis and they don't want to look into the reasons for it.
This idea that Trump policies, canceling them, affected the numbers, just not true, being debunked again and again. And even this whole idea about the border crisis, do we call it a crisis? Calling something a crisis is not something, it doesn't have some objective definition in politics, nor is it something only Republicans get to do. We, the media, decide if something is a crisis.
I was at the forefront of calling out the Trump administration for these inhumane and cruel policies like family separation. I will say that there is a difference between the Biden administration and the Trump administration.
Anyone who's using the term surge around you consciously is trying to invoke a militaristic frame, which, by the way, is a white supremacist idea, philosophy.
Listen. This is a totally different story from the kids in cages narrative created by the left a few short years ago.
I will release children from cages.
We're not going to separate families. We're not going to put any kids in cages.
I have seen the cages of babies.
Putting kids in cages at the border? Separating families? I mean, that's not what we've done. That's not who we are.
No civilized country should treat people like this, even undocumented migrants.
Heartbreaking and gut-wrenching. This image of powerful symbol of the border crisis.
Fences resembling cages. The report demands immediate action, quoting a facility manager who likens conditions there to a ticking time bomb. There is a crisis at the southern border.
So let's just compare the numbers, the numbers. Last February, 36,000 crossed the border under Trump, compared to 100,000 under Biden. That's a 174% increase. I thought the left believed in math. And the CBP projects as many as 184,000 unaccompanied children could cross the southwest border this year.